from seemingly countless bands, each one of them better than the next, each incarnation better than the next. And I gotta tell you that as hard as it is to believe, given the quality of his work 20 years ago, the songs are better and better each time. He's got a new record that's here at the festival. It's called John Wayne, right? Called John Wayne, you should pick it up. This guy is one of the best that has ever been in CCM. In about 90 seconds, you are gonna hear from Terry Taylor.
Baby, watch, Jessica, do the speed, do the speed, do the speed. Cornerstone new wave. It's a song off a really obscure record. It's a song called Feels Logic.
That's not theologically correct. My grandma's up there waiting. She spoke to me one night. Said the man inside this pain that you will be alright. I hope this is, but I get no respect. Theo says that's not theologically correct. Jesus spoke to me only once out of people's church. When I was down on my luck, he offered me the cure.
Thank you. I hope you guys are prepared for a sort of a long night. Hopefully it won't feel long, but you know, we want to do a lot of things. We're going to bring somebody up here to help us out right now. Now you guys all know,
where's
Michelle's gonna help us out on this one. We'll be right back.
Little doggies, you're home. And we'll bring up the good.
shore, all alone. Love and hate are here within me, and it scares me to think how angry I have grown. Finish a chapter, write a new page. Last man standing, it's a start over again. There are the figures of things found in the age. And I walk out singing, ah, yippee-ki, yippee-ki-yay. I walk out singing, ah, yippee-ki, yippee-ki-yay.
This is off the Calhoun record. Yeah! One of our many worldwide hits. We'll be right back.
to the Father of Light. Hangs on the neck of forever. She vows to yell, calling the safety net. She prays, she yells, if the safety net, she starts leaving again. Leaving the rocks, girls in white. Arms are not to cross frozen ground. You're gonna call me a liar. I try to tell you what's coming down.
We never know if we can do it. This is like, oh, we hope everybody, you know, does good on it. And we always say at practice, we always go, just follow Terry. Because if he screws up, then, you know, the band's just going to have to fall in on it. Did we do that tonight?
We did that tonight.
We did that?
I was right behind you, following you all the way.
Andy, you're nothing but a sheep. You need to get yourself up. I'm only a man.
I'm sorry.
I love you, kids.
Cynical, I put you on a cross. So mean
do one of those rock things.
You rule!
I never could do that. Rock Sombrero. Who remembered that? Who said that? Who said the Rock Sombrero?
Out in the cold!
If I have to come out... I remember hearing a story recently where Billy Graham went to Russia. And he caused a lot of controversy in the church. And, you know, Billy, you know, he didn't confront them on the political issues or even religious issues. What is that? Anyway, so, anyway, his aide was in the, you know, in the car with him, and he said, you know, there's all these religious figures in the church that are saying, you know, he set back the church 75 years. And Billy said, I'm really, really sad about that. He said, I meant to send it back 2,000 years. All right? I don't know, man. I just love the guy. I love the guy. And so he wrote a little ditty for him. And the chorus is just short, it's his name, and if you would, let's sort of dedicate it to the guy. Maybe one day the guy will hear it and he'll get all offended and hate me. No, I'm kidding. I'm sure he would like the song, hopefully. Point to that day in your life where you thought you lost a part of, you know, who your childlikeness, your that moment when something was revealed in your life or some tragedy came in your life where you kind of can look back now and go, yeah, that was the moment when I started moving out of that innocence and seeing that the world can be not only a beautiful, wonderful place with a lot of lovely things, but it can be a place of an enormous evil and tragedy. And that evil is a mystery in many ways, and people don't often like to talk about mystery because they figure if you know enough scriptures, then there is no mystery. There's no mystery about God. There's no mystery about life. There's no mystery about evil because there's a scripture. Of course, sometimes what God sort of does in our lives is he sort of brings tragedy into our lives so that we begin to understand the suffering of Christ and in suffering as Christ suffered, we become more Christ-like. I think it's an interesting thing that Christ didn't lose his wounds after the resurrection. But my loss of innocence, I drove to my elementary school just the other day, Palisades in Southern California, and I remember the day I was in Spanish class, and it was a beautiful time of the year. Southern California skies were blue, and I was in my class, and somebody came over the speaker and said, we have an announcement. The president has been shot. And I thought, the president of the school? You know? Because I was still somewhat childlike. I couldn't imagine beyond that it was the president of the school. No, it was the president of the United States. And I think that changed the country in profound ways that we still feel today. And I remember the night that I was in bed after this terrible tragedy, and then to see more death on television with Oswald getting shot, and the country was going crazy. And then I remember a young man named Robert Kennedy, and I thought, well, maybe there's still hope and we can get back to Camelot and we can, you know, have something that we had once again. And I was laying in bed one night, my mother opened the door to my bed, to the bedroom, and said, Terry, pray right now. Robert Kennedy's been shot. And I wept, and I went to the television, and I looked at it, and I was stunned. I thought, Lord, what's happening? And I wasn't even Christian, but I think that was the beginning of crying out to God, because I lost that innocence, and I wanted something in my life that I could rely on through the tragedies that we all face. And this is a song that I wrote. I had this title for many years. I put off writing because I wrote a few lines. I didn't like them, and I didn't think they were worthy of the title. And finally, I think it sort of expressed something about the country and what we may all be feeling even now about where we're headed. And it's called Amber Ways of Time.
Consequence.
now. Danny boy. Bright white crosses line the hillside. So long, Danny boy. She prayed to heaven, but you still died. Please come back, Danny boy. God bless the poor she left in the streets. Lord, she heard those babies cry, those little
experience. I kept getting this line in my head, you know. I float on a cloud between the boy and the ball. And I thought, where is this going? And then I thought about Chrome Delmore and I thought about mermaids. So anyway, and on the ball field they played, there was a place called Buffalo Hills. And I thought that was appropriate because it was again, a song about innocence and innocence of children and how vulnerable they are, as are buffalo. And that's where he played, you know? So, thus the song, Buffalo Hills. Gary's not gonna do the song with me. We're winging it here, man.
Gary!
Thank you.
disguised as men in dark suits and masks. In the center of a galaxy, I breathe bright stars and planets. Sun dips to kiss the earth. My angel makes the
we'll be right back. Okay.
And know that
weeks to come. Stick around. I love you too.
You people nuts? That wasn't me. I didn't do that.
All of the monkeys drinking great pine and wine and thunder, grapes and red. The ice cream stands and salt and truck stops. All the diggers and the olive break. Coca-Cola and the no-tell motels. Barbershops and burner shades. We'll think the dust storms coming over the farmland style. It's like you're tuning up the party act. When you imagine picking up soldiers coming home for Christmas with Scarlett and Gabrielle Kerouac. It's for the patchwork of Americana, Julio's and the River Plate. Now the message from the moon of the highway, pay attention to the sign that says Jesus says. Soundtracks, soft shoulders, washouts, bus and stops and record drivers. Sometimes the world just gotta happen to us.
Chat room is, so people aren't really chatting, they're bellowing.
it's really an interesting thing. And it's always people with this dogma. I think you should have dogma in your life, but it's like, you know, compassion is kind of dogma. These people just are sort of just blaring these scriptures constantly, which is, I guess, good in some ways. I'm confused about the whole thing, but it's really interesting because there's just always, there's not chatting, it's arguing and that sort of thing. And Tom and I were talking last night, he said, you know, it's finding the simplicity of the gospel, and really what it all comes down to, because everybody has sort of these different concepts of what God looks like or whatever, these things. But there's these sort of, you know, dots, and then maybe they're like this, one down here. And we're supposed to connect the dots, and that's the skeleton of the gospel, you know. It's Christ's death and his resurrection. It's loving God with all that you are, and loving your neighbor as yourself. And some people just connect the dots like this. And other people go like this. And other people go like this. And that's what makes us individual. But as long as the dots are connected, then we're there. We could say brother, sister. And anyway, I don't know what this has to do with this song, but we're going to try and connect the dots on this one, I guess.
Ready?
Over and out.
bleeds till she is the color of the moonlight. And the angels wrap her in their feathered arms. They cannot conceal her from the darkest night. And he didn't say a word.
What?
up front with a big Dove outfit on. But... All right, here we go, John Wayne. Cool. Isn't it a great song?
Tell all your friends.
Tell all your friends.
Well, I'm in a mess and I need a friend. I've been thinking about success and now the story might end. But with friends like these, then you tell me.
Us back to our country roots, where we should have stayed the whole time. And we know that in getting back to our country roots, we're getting back to our first love and repentance and confessing our whole career has been one giant mistake. We could have been doing cowpunk, you guys.
Yeah. couple of special guests going to join us on the song. I want everybody to join along and do your thing. Somebody should be making their way up here right now. Where are you?
Right there, here he is.
Where's Ricky?
Thank you.
Right.
might make some people uncomfortable or whatever. Matter of fact, I'm always making people uncomfortable. What's the big deal?
No!
I live to make people uncomfortable. No, we were talking the other night about, Christian music and history and how there's no sense of it. For people that sort of began when they first heard that one song on the radio, and that could have happened, or somebody's friend's house, that could have happened in any era, So for them, Christian music started then, and there's not been any kind of real chronological history set forth, but just playing that song brought back memories for me, and the people that I think need to be shown some respect and acknowledged for what they contributed, not only to, taking Christian music into a place where we could explore as artists, they got sort of beyond just simply, being musical missionaries, I should say. Which is a good thing too. But, that we could, within the forum, explore, creativity and all those things. And there's a guy that I love very much, and I think needs to be acknowledged as the guy that sort of got the whole ball rolling. That's Larry Norton. Anyway, this is a song that we think you'll recognize, and we just want to thank you guys for coming out and sticking with us. And I got to tell you sincerely, the reason that we put together, 460 songs or whatever we've done here tonight is not because we were anxious to learn 4 billion chords in order to do them, but because we knew we were coming here and that you would be here. And you deserve it. And what you give us and what we take back is immeasurable. And I can't even begin to articulate it, what this means to me and what it means to my friends here on the stage and how it brings us together. We got in last night, some of us straggling or whatever, we were up till 4 a.m. and just being with each other and sharing something common, not only the good times, the bad times, our failings, our victories, whatever, but our pain, whatever it may be, but sharing a common thing of Christ, and he's the one that, helps us to be transparent before each other. And the greatest joy that I can have, since I don't tour that much and sort of in the studio rap kind of guy, I guess, is to come here and get this kind of energy and also to appreciate you. At one point, I didn't appreciate you guys. There was a time I was angry. I was angry at some of the stuff that came down. And I was bitter and I had to go through that. And I had to live my life in that fishbowl. And there were fully capable of coming up to you, throwing up on you. And it wasn't easy for me to handle that. And over the years, as I guess, hopefully age, hopefully in my case, means a little bit of wisdom, I've learned to love the people that support, that pray, that write me and say that the music means something in their lives beyond just something to put on it. And here in the background, but that God has used it in their lives to do incredible things. And I can truly stand here tonight and say with all my heart that I love you guys. Thank God for you. And hang in there. Fight the good fight.
I'm going out.
wrote it. Trying to figure out, you know, what would be appropriate for the evening, and I think we figured something out. I love to go wandering along the mountain track, and as I go, I love to sing my knapsack on my back. I'm